Time now to check on the thermal performance of the Samsung Galaxy Tab S8 Ultra that I have. 14.6 inch screen. This version has 8 GB of RAM, 128 GB of storage, the Wi-Fi only model. I'm going to test out various different benchmarks, stress it right out, and see just how hot is that Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 going to get. Will it thermal throttle? And if so, how much? How hot is it going to get? Will it become a overheating throttling mess like I've seen in some of these Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 phones? Well, let's find out. So let's jump straight into this. I have right here, you can see no recent apps, so the memory's clear. Now I have the 8 GB RAM version with 128 GB of UFS 3.1 storage. The app I'll use first is 3D Mark here. Now this is the wildlife extreme test that I'm gonna do, which a lot of people before my other video said that's not realistic. It's going to push the hardware to the absolute limit. It's 20 minutes long, so we'll see just how long will it last before it starts to throttle down that performance. And with my thermal imaging camera, we'll take a look and see just how hot is it going to get. So let's start this now. Okay, so it's just about to finish, and there we go. It's finished. You can see it's throttled down here to 37.4% of its performance. And that happened around about the 5 minute mark, the fifth loop starts to dip down, and on the sixth definitely. And it was quite stable, but look, it started to actually pick up a little bit on the end there. So I'm gonna have a look at the thermals now with my thermal imaging camera. We'll see just how hot is it getting after 20 minutes of stressing it out. All right, so I can see that just around the top here, that's where their chipset is. 33 degrees Celsius, so that's actually not too bad, 33, because I've seen 50 degrees on this Xiaomi 12 and the 12 Pro. I will flip it over now, and we'll take a look at the back, because that's where I do feel a bit of heat, and you can see that that's excellent. That is really good, about the same kind of temperature, so 33 degrees after just 20 minutes of the Wildlife Extreme stress test. Now the next set of benchmarks to really stress and push it is going to be this one, AnTuTu benchmark. To make things interesting, I'm also going to add a different form factor but with the exact same chipset, and it's this, the Xiaomi 12 Pro. Now this model here has the same chipset, which of course is that Snapdragon 8 Gen 1, but in the smaller form factor, is it going to get a lot hotter? How much hotter it's going to get, and how much more is it going to throttle? So AnTuTu on both of them, just check there's nothing in the background here. There's nothing running in the background. Both of them are cold, all right? So it's even, it's fair here. Ambient temperatures are 24 degrees Celsius at the moment. So AnTuTu benchmark here on both of these. Open them up. All right, and just confirm they're both version 9.2.9. You can see the previous scores, quite a bit of a difference there. Samsung to me have throttled it down a little bit, but what they've done makes more sense as you'll see later on, because it doesn't get as hot. So what I'll do is test this again and let this run, and we'll check on how they are, the performance drop on the next run. So remember that score, and we'll see what's going to happen here now with the phone versus the tablet. All right, so they just finished up. A bit of a difference there, quite a big difference between them. So looking at my thermal imaging camera, you can see that the front of the screens here, the Xiaomi's at 35 degrees, and we're only at approximately 27 or so on the S8 Ultra. What I'll do now is run the benchmark again, because I wanna see how much are they going to throttle. So here we go, let's just do round two on this. The benchmark results will get out of that screen. And we'll do it, test again. Okay, so they've just finished up and we've dropped about 20,000 points only on the Xiaomi 12 Pro. And we actually got a better score here on the S8 Ultra, which is unusual. So I'm gonna do one more loop here and then I'll call it quits, but I will check on the last loop. I'll have a look at the thermals. So let's do this, test again. All right, so the Xiaomi has finished up first there and it does throttle down even more, but not by too much. So that's only now dropped by approximately, what, about 10,000 points and a little bit more than that, about 17 that it's dropped again. And here we go, you can see that now the Samsung has dropped a bit. So the best score it got was 903,000 points. So it's gone down a little bit. Well, what about those thermals? You can see that it's up to 41 degrees here on the front of the phones here with the Xiaomi. So the Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 in a phone, of course, smaller form factor. This makes complete sense. It's normal, all right? This is dissipating so much more heat. It's really large. So that's the front of them. Let's flip them over. And you see the back of the phone here getting a little hot, 40 degrees almost. But not too bad. That's good. The worst I've seen it actually get is up to about 50. What about the huge Tab S8 Ultra here? So the back of that one, oh, look at that. That's really good. Let me just move this third marker here onto where it looks quite warm. So it's really only getting up to about 29 degrees around there. So that's excellent so far with the thermals on it. I mean, it's just dissipating and getting rid of that heat so quickly on the larger tablet. It makes complete sense that the phone's struggling here, getting a bit hot to the touch. And it's time to now really step it up a notch here, play the most demanding game, which is Genshin Impact. I'm going to run the highest possible settings, the highest preset, but I will set it to 60 frames per second. It's going to really push this game hard, and we'll see if it runs into any noticeable throttling that I can detect. Now, unfortunately, the game launcher here doesn't give us a frames per second count, and that game plugin that a few people have asked me to run, it doesn't show up, okay? The frames per second, it just states it's not supported, so I can't run that yet. So it took a little while to load the game in here, and you can see that there's pretty fast. So settings-wise, let's take a look what I've got here set just to confirm that under graphics, you can see custom because I have it set to this. So you go highest, all right? And it's just going to state I need to restart, but I've already done that. So it's still already in the highest possible settings. And then 60 frames per second overclocked. So I'm going to now play this for approximately an hour, okay? And we'll see how hot it gets and will it lag out completely. Now, I've only been playing for about 35 minutes, and there's no point me really going on too much more. Now, I've seen a few lags. It definitely does lag out now and then, just a few frame dips on these top settings, which is to be expected. But what I have seen is the thermal's just topping out about 37 degrees. That's it. And you can see right now with my thermal imaging camera that, yes, it's about 35 degrees, and that's really all it's going to get up to. And I'll just quickly flip it over and we'll have a look at the back now after 35 minutes of really one of the most demanding Android games here. And now look at that. Well, getting up to about 37. So I have seen it peak around 38, but 39, it's not really going over that. Now, bear in mind that if you do use a case or you've got the cover on it, that it will get a little bit hotter. Really great to see that this did not turn into an overheating, throttling mess. What I have seen with some of the Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 phones, they just simply don't have good thermals in there, haven't put enough copper, transfer heat pipes, whatever. It's not good enough because I've seen some of those phones completely just crash and burn, closing a demanding game like Genshin Impact, completely booting you out of it. Not going to happen here with the Samsung Galaxy S8 Ultra. It just goes and goes and goes. So I don't have a case on it. So if, of course, if you're gaming with a case, I don't currently have any on hand, or a cover over it, then it will get a little bit hotter there. But I do think that Samsung have put a lot of work into this to make sure the thermals are good. So it does throttle, as we're seeing with the Wildlife Extreme Stress Test. That's normal. This is how these chips work. When they are at the top clocks there, getting very hot, they're generating a bit of heat. Eventually, they're going to drop down those GPU clocks and the CPU clocks in order to control that heat. But a tablet like this, it has a massive amount of space. It's got an alloy body, unibody, and it is simply using all of that really as a huge passive heat sink to dissipate that heat without any issues. So fantastic thermals on this. I think in my time testing it and now gaming, with something as demanding as Genshin Impact, not a problem. The only thing is, as I pointed out in my first video, a little large and uncomfortable for gaming such a huge tablet like this. So make sure you check out my other videos on Samsung's Galaxy S8 Ultra. There will be an emulation video that I'm currently working on, and that will be pushing it again to the limit to see what kind of performance we can expect with popular emulators with the S8 Ultra here.